It's of a threefold lady, as certain scholars say, to whom the tribes of Europe in ancient times did pray. We're all in this together, we're none of us alone. All hail the triple goddess, the maiden, nymph, and crone. To make their fields to flourish, their custom I'll now sing. Though staunchly matriarchal, they choose a sacred king. And give him feasts and honor, a garland for his head. The tribal nymph to lie with, until they killed him dead. Now every year they killed one, but that seemed awfully rough. So then they made it 8 years, which scarce was long enough. Till finally extended, his reign was years 19, which he's no doubt the good king, and gratified his queen. Yet loath to die we all are, and in our final twist, a substitute was chosen, a boy called the Tannist, who played the king's part gaily until the fateful hour. And on his death the real king resumed his former power. Now some call it bloodthirsty to murder boys and men, and others say it's nonsense to claim that way back then. A single triple goddess who slaughters and who saves was worshipped by our forebears, but so writes Robert Graves. The Greeks, they had three graces, three gorgons and three fates, and triple-headed Cerberus, who guarded Hades' gates. Three daughters fair of Hesperus, and others I forgot. Suggest a triple goddess just might have been or not.